A Dubuque playground that was constructed without the traditional swings, seesaws, and slides still became one of the most beloved by children of the 1960s, 70s, and 80s. The Telegraph Herald lauded the concept because of its unique attractions, noting, "Adults will wish they were kids again, and kids will be glad they are." In April 1954, the city of Dubuque began making plans for its newly acquired property east of Cheney Road between Wilbrick Lane and Pennsylvania Avenue. The Silver Acres horse racing track had just been gifted to the city by William S. Molo via the Wallert Foundation. Combined with the recently purchased Sylvester Place parcel and adjacent city-owned land, a special recreation center for Dubuque's west side would soon take shape. The 28-acre Flora Park would be named in honor of Harry Wallert's late wife. Ground was broken for a 75 by 198-foot pool that summer. It opened on July 31, 1955, on a 96-degree day in the midst of a heat wave. Tennis courts and baseball fields were added the following year. Long-range plans included areas for croquet, horseshoes, basketball, volleyball, badminton, handball, ice skating, and hockey. Development of the park took another step in 1958 when the Dubuque Junior Chamber of Commerce announced plans for a modernistic playground in the park's northern section. It would be modeled after Dennis the Menace Playground in Monterey, California. That site was designed by Dennis's creator, cartoonist Hank Ketchum. Dubuque's version was conceived by J.C. Peter J. Tacos. Charles Ray Jr. was the initial project chairman and would be succeeded by Thomas Loosbrock. Work began September 13, 1958, with J.C.'s pouring concrete for a tricycle path that would wind through the area. Among the planned attractions, some which never came to fruition, were a whale-drinking fountain, a balancing bridge, a floating raft anchored in a one-foot-deep pool, a spring gym, an airplane, a swing gate, and a multi-purpose amalgamation of plastic chutes and ladders dubbed The Thing. But the piece de resistance would be the umbrella tree, a structure composed of steel reinforcing rods for climbing like Tarzan and supporting poles that children could slide down like junior firemen. The colorful, wavy plastic canopy that was to crown the design never materialized. The apparatus would become known by locals as the rocket ship or birdcage. Each piece of play equipment would rise out of a bed of sand surrounded by concrete curbing. Construction began in late summer 1959. The J.C.'s had raised money to cover the cost of the project and handled most of the work. Days before its July 22, 1960 grand opening, the playground received an exclusive toy, a 1918 fire engine that was retired by the city's John Deere plant. Children could sit in the front seat, grasp the steering wheel, and race to an imaginary fire where they'd save the day. The playground was formally dedicated on October 16, 1960, with Loosbrock and city manager Gilbert Chavanel ascending the umbrella tree. But the final and most unique piece to be added to the site arrived in April 1961. Hector Garcia's Clark College art class had been tasked with creating an animal-themed interactive sculpture. The female students fashioned models of their ideas and presented them to the J.C.'s. The chosen entry was designed by junior art major Joan Dubay of Des Moines. Randolph the Pentapus, a five-tentacled creature with gigantic eyes, was a hit. Sculpted by the students with concrete over a rebar frame, it stood 5 feet tall and spanned 18 feet. "I was thrilled with the design," said Joan Dubay Tully, now of Dubuque. "The kids could climb on it, climb into it, just be part of the sculpture. They could crawl in the backside, and they could look out the eyes. We made it big enough so adults could crawl in, too." It was originally supposed to be painted pink with purple polka dots all over it. Randolph was the crowning glory for a playground that became a mecca for area youngsters for the next several decades. Ketchum's goal in designing his Monterey site was to give children a place to explore and imagine. In Dubuque, that dream was fulfilled at Flora Park.